coach.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for attending tonight's game. And to our visitors, Lockhart, please drive home safely. And everybody, drive home safely and buckle up. My name is Randy Stevens, the voice of the Rattlers. And everyone, have a safe drive home.
Appreciate you. Shake fans hands.
Hey, what are you playing for? What are we going to do?
Congratulations, Coach.
Hot day.
How about that? San Marcos Rattlers in the 2015 state playoffs. Good, not a boy. That's amazing. It's amazing. These kids work their tails off. These coaches work their tails off. These fans cheer as loud as they can. So for it all to come together in 2015 was pretty special. What was going through my mind was score. We got to score. I mean, there was no ifs, ands, or buts about it. However we scored didn't matter. We needed to score. And so the kids just did what they had to do. Kids did what they had to do, and they executed. I mean, that trick play was, I don't know, double passing. I don't know. I saw it yesterday, or the day before yesterday. I said, Coach, what are you doing? It's our trick play. Okay. And so, hey, Coach. Hey, Coach Sierra. Where's Coach Sierra at? Coach Sierra! That's amazing.
Just talk about that.
Oh, God, he was playing outside his shoes.
Right.
He was playing. Come here. They want to know about the trick play.
To be honest with you, that's a play I ran in high school. It was the same thing.
Oh!
I was in my high school in the same district. We ran that play against these guys. I figured, might as well take it out of their hat. And,
it's the perfect execution, too. The offense has been executing all year long. Oh, man. You know, we had to have something. And Wilburn has come up big the entire season. So for that senior to play his best ball and get that ball out, it's just amazing. It's a testament to how he works. I mean, this guy is banged up, bruised, battered, and he comes out every play and plays hard.
And lastly, just talking about the defense of the floor. You know, 10-yard drive, easily get the ball.
Don't use that word demoralized. We're not going to get demoralized. There ain't no way. They're mentally ready because of all the things they've done since January. They've done boot camp. It was 10 times as hard as that game right there. So they were ready for this game mentally, physically, and spiritually.
I'll tell you what. Words cannot describe what I feel like right now. I mean, it's just freaking amazing. It's freaking amazing. Holy hell! We're in the playoffs now. I'm not surprised. I'm not surprised at all, because we started with you guys. You guys have heard it for 4 years straight. It's ingrained in you, just like these other guys over here. So I'm not surprised at all. I'm just amazed on how we did it. That was a hell of a game against a good bunch. They wanted it just as bad as you do, but at the end, they had to do what they had to do. I am just so stinking proud of you. Let's talk about defense, Coach. Go.
You know, Dean, we've been through a lot, man. We've been through some ups and downs, and the downs have been real low. And we've been through some highs, but the highs were, you know, we experienced some good highs this year. But you guys stuck together. You guys stuck together and you understood what it was to play together. You know, it was something that has been coming for a long time. You know, when you win games like this, the games that we talked to you guys about 4 years ago, when we talked to you about thousands of people, when we talked to you about playoff atmospheres, when we talked to you about making those stops, this is what we were talking about. And the last 4 years, this is what I have not done. I've never questioned the good Lord above. You want me to tell you why? Because His timing is perfect. His timing is the best timing. His day is the best day. His week is the best week. I've never questioned Him, because I knew He had us right here this day. Defense, you balled your asses off, and you made one hell of a play when we needed it.
Mm-hmm.
And you looked me straight in the eyes, and I told you, go get the football. And that's exactly what you guys did. Hell of a job. Congratulations. Good job.
Guys, I am extremely proud of every single one of you guys. Every single one of you guys came to play tonight, and just the electricity that was coming from the sideline. You know, nobody was getting down on each other. We were picking each other up. We told you it was going to be a tough battle, and you guys stuck together. Stuck together. I kept hearing, we got you offense, we got you offense. Defense, you came up big tonight. You came up, he said, man, we struggled early. We turned the ball over. Right? We don't preach that. We don't even say anything about turnovers, but it happened. But you stuck with us. You stuck with us. And then to hear the offense talking in the second half, when our time comes, we're going to put that ball in the end zone. And sure enough, you did. You did, man. I want you to know, guys, man, we talk about hard work, and it's evident. It's evident that hard work does pay off. You guys deserve every bit of what you got tonight. Getting in the playoffs, man, that is awesome. That is freaking awesome. Congratulations. Proud of y'all. Love y'all, guys.
All I know is I've seen a lot of you guys grow up as freshmen, get your butts in the weight room, and not only grow up physically, but grow up as young men in the way you think about things. I told the linemen before we started the week, I said, you guys go make history in this week. Go make history in this game. Go do something that hadn't been done in a while and set that as your goal. I'm so excited to be part of what we're doing here. It is amazing. It's fun to watch you guys play. Fun to watch the spirit and what comes from within when you guys take the field. Congratulations.
Hey, let's thank the Lord real quick, then let's count it out. You guys remember how to count it out? All right, grab a hand.
Nice and loud, boys.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom, power, and glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Now, I'm pretty sure maybe some of these reporters will know. Do we have Harlandale or Highlands?
It should be Harlandale.
Huh? It's tied right now. Okay. We won't know until the Tybee game and the Heights game is over. It's tied. If Heights gets in, we take the fourth spot and we play Highlands at Alamo Stadium, which is one of the oldest stadiums in San Antonio. That's where you want to start off your playoff career, believe me. I've won quite a bit in that place. If Heights gets beat, then we will play Harlandale, and we're not sure exactly where we're going to play that one yet because we got to talk after the game because they're playing McCullum too. Somebody check that score. All right. Everybody remember how to count it out. You got to start slow and go fast. And then when we finish, we're going to win. We got to win. All right. You understand? How many points?
35.
35?
35.
Right there. Get up there. Get up there.
Chris, y'all going this way, I'm going this way. Here we go, ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18.